Hello, my dear students. Let us discuss one example on IS code method. Let us take this example. A rectangular footing has a size of 1.8 meter by 3 meter has to transmit the load of a column at a depth of 1.5 meter. Calculate the safe load which the footing can carry at a factor of safety of 3 against shear failure. Use IS code method. The soil has following properties. N is nothing but porosity equal to 40%, G is equal to 2.67, W water content is equal to 15%, C is equal to 8 kilonewton per meter square, and phi is equal to 32.5 degree. Okay, and NC, NQ, N gamma values are given for 32.5 degree. Now, what you have to calculate? You have to calculate the safe load. So, to calculate the safe load, first you have to calculate safe bearing capacity, safe pressure. Okay, how you can calculate safe pressure? First, you have to calculate ultimate bearing pressure, then net ultimate bearing pressure, and then safe bearing pressure. Here, what you can observe is some soil properties are given like N, G and W. But gamma value is not given, but we required gamma value. How you can calculate gamma value? This you have studied in first unit, index properties. If you have N value, you can calculate E. What is E? E is equal to void ratio. So, void ratio is equal to N divided by 1 minus N. This is the relationship between porosity and void ratio. So, substitute N value, that is in percentage. So, convert into this 0.4 divided 100, 40 divided by 100, 0.4. 1 minus 0.4, that is equal to 0.667. So E is equal to 0.667. We know that there is one formula for dry density, that is gamma D equal to G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E. Okay, so here G is given, that is 2.67 into gamma W, that is equal to 9.81 divided by 1 plus E. E is equal to 0.667 calculated value. So equal to 15.71 kilonewton per meter cube. This is gamma D. But we require gamma value, bulk density value in the formula. So, how you can calculate? There is a relationship between bulk density and dry density. What is that? Dry density is equal to bulk density gamma divided by 1 plus W. So, how you can calculate gamma? You can rewrite the equation. So, that is equal to gamma is equal to gamma D into 1 plus W. We have gamma D value, that is 15.71 into 1 plus W. W is nothing but moisture content or water content, that is 15%. So you can take it as 0.15. So calculate gamma value, that is equal to 18.07 kilonewton per meter square. So now you know gamma value. Right, then now you can start calculating the bearing pressure, ultimate bearing capacity. Here it is given that general shear failure, it is not given. If it is not given, you can consider always general shear failure. If it is specified local shear failure, you have to use that values for NC, NQ and gamma. Now here general shear failure, what IS code says? Ultimate bearing capacity, what I have taken here, net ultimate bearing, I have taken QNF. Okay, so if you take QNF, that is nothing but QF minus gamma D. QF, that is equal to all this formula, but here minus 1 will not be there. Okay, if you can write in terms of QF also, then this only NQ, NQ minus 1 will not be there. Okay, but now what I have considered here, net ultimate bearing capacity. Net ultimate bearing capacity is nothing but QF minus gamma D. Okay, so I have used in this equation only. So QNF is equal to CNC SC DC into IC plus sigma dash into, here actually what is that, gamma d it comes, but here I have considered qnf, so that is nq minus 1 into sq dq iq plus half into beta gamma into n gamma s gamma d gamma I gamma into w dash. Okay, this is slightly different from Terzaghi's analysis. Till now we have calculated all the values like ultimate bearing capacity, safe bearing capacity using Terzaghi's analysis. Terzaghi doesn't, he didn't consider shape factor, depth factor and inclination factor. But as per IS code, there is a shape factor, depth factor and inclination factor. So that we have considered here. Then rest everything is same. Okay. Finding ultimate bearing capacity, net ultimate bearing capacity and safe bearing capacity. That method is same. Only the formula is different. And here in Terzaghi's analysis, we have considered RW1 and RW2 for second and third term. But here, there is no water table contents for the second term. Only there is a W dash, that is water content factor in the last term. Okay, W dash. So, that you remember, that is the difference between Terzaghi's analysis and IS code method. Now, we have to calculate, we have C value. We have NC value. We have to calculate what is SC, what is DC and what is IC. Similarly, SQ, DQ, IQ and S gamma, N gamma, S gamma, D gamma and I gamma. So now since the load is vertical, see here in this problem there is no inclination load. Okay, the load is not given. I mean inclination is not given. Alpha value is not given. So we can consider it as a vertical load. So the load is vertical. So if the load is vertical, then directly you can take IC equal to IQ is equal to I gamma equal to 1. Okay, and here there is no water table effects anywhere. So directly you can consider W dash is equal to 1. Okay, so now otherwise if there is a inclination, okay, that if there is alpha values given, you have to calculate IC, IQ and I gamma. How you can calculate? Using this formula. Okay, this formula IC is equal to IQ is equal to 1 minus alpha divided by 90 the whole square. But here alpha is not given, so directly you can take it as 0. So then it becomes IC, IQ, that all equal to 1 only. Okay, now next thing what it is you have to calculate here in this problem, you have to find SC, SQ, S gamma. As per IS code, SC is equal to, for the rectangular footing, SC is equal to shape factor, that is equal to 1 plus 0.2 into B divided by N. Okay, so we substitute all the values 1 plus 0.2 into B. B is B into L. This is B is 1.8 divided by L, that is D. B into D, that is nothing but 3. So that is 3. So, simplify, you get 1.12. Similarly, calculate SQ, that is equal to 1 plus 0.2 B divided by L, that is equal to again 1.12. S gamma, that is equal to 1 minus 0.4 into B divided by L, that is equal to 1 minus 0.4 into 1.8 divided by 3 equal to 0.76. Okay, now shape factors are calculated. Next, let us calculate depth factor. What is the depth factor? This is the formula. DC is equal to 1 plus 0.2 times of D divided by B square root of N phi. Okay, where N phi, square root of N phi is equal to, this is the formula, tan of 45 plus pi by 2. What is tan? Calculate this value. Tan is equal to 45 plus pi is equal to given value 32.5. It is given here 32.5. Okay, divided by 2. equal to 1.823, that is square root of n phi. Now you can calculate what is dc. Dc is equal to 1 plus 0.2 into d. D is depth of the footing, that is 1.5 meter, the depth, the load, transmit the load of a column at a depth of 1.5 meter. So that is d. D is equal to 1.5 divided by b. B is width, that is given 1.8 meter. So 1.8 into square root of n phi, that is equal to 1.823, equal to 1.304. Okay. Next, similarly, you have to calculate dq and d gamma, that is equal to 1 plus 0.1 into d divided by b square root of n phi. Okay, this is for phi is equal to, phi is greater than 10 degree. This value formula is applicable only when phi is greater than 10. Our case phi is equal to 32.5. So we have to use this formula. Otherwise, directly you can take dq is equal to d gamma is equal to 1 as per IS code method. Okay, see here, you can see that formula here. DC, yeah, here, okay, where dq is equal to d gamma is equal to 1 if phi is less than 10. If dc dq is equal to, you have to use this formula when phi is greater than 10. Okay, and shape factor, I have considered this formula, okay, for the shape factor SC, SQ, S gamma for the rectangular section, rectangular footing. Now, let us come to this problem. Okay, here. So, substitute in this equation 1 plus 0.1 into D. Depth of the footing is 1.5 divided by B 1.8 into square root of NQ, N phi, that is 1.823. So, we will get 1.152. So, now also calculate overburden pressure, that is nothing but gamma d. Gamma is equal to bulk density, not dry density value, that is equal to 18.07 here, calculated value, into d. D is depth of the footing, 1.5, we get 27.105 kilonewton per meter square. Now we have the values of IC, IQ, I gamma, SC, SQ, S gamma, and DC, DQ, D gamma. Now we can use the formula in that equation, this equation, QNF is equal to C, LC, SC, DC, IC. So in that, use that formula, C is 8 given into NC 38.13. into 1.1312, that is DC, and into 1.304, that is DC, and 1.12 is SC, okay, 1.12 is SC, and this is IC. Okay, so substitute. Then again, next term, that is equal to gamma. Gamma is equal to calculated here, that is, sigma dash, that is equal to gamma into D, 27.105 into NQ minus 1, okay? Substitute the values, NQ is, so here gamma D into 25.81 minus 1 into DSC into DC value here, dq d gamma value 1.152 into iq. Okay, then last term, that is half into b into gamma into n gamma s gamma d gamma, yeah, half into b is breadth 1.8 into gamma, that is bulk density 18.07 into n gamma 35.21 into s gamma 0.76 d gamma 1.152 into I gamma that is 1. So simplify this, we get NQNF. Once if you get QNF, you can calculate QS. What is that? Safe load is equal to QNF divided by F plus gamma d. Q and F is equal to 1815.89 divided by 3 plus gamma into d. That is 18.07 into 1.5. We get this. So here it is asked to calculate safe load. What is safe load? Safe load is nothing but pressure into area. Why? Pressure is equal to load divided by area. Here we have to calculate load. So load is equal to pressure into area. So pressure, that is safe pressure, 632.4 into area. Area of the rectangular footing, B into L. B is 1.8 and L is 3. So we will get 3415 kilonewton. I hope all of you understood. Thank you.